In less than 1 hour, a cumulus cluster would explode into a powerful supercell, producing violent tornadoes with enough power to suck the roof off a house and toss its fragments 100 meters. One tornado claimed a man's life, and inside another mile-wide monster, a young man would take shelter in his bathroom while the rest of his house was completely obliterated around him.
Listen to that sucker.
This is the story of the horrific tornadoes, its victims, and its survivors. This is the story of the May 9th, 2016 Katie-Wynnewood Sulphur Oklahoma tornadoes. 3 days prior to May 9th, the Storm Prediction Center caught wind of the potential for tornadoes in eastern Oklahoma, and on the morning of May 9th hatched a 10% chance of tornadoes, later upgraded with a chance of significant or powerful tornadoes, EF2 and above, outlined in black. At 2:30 p.m., a tornado watch was issued, and at 3:09, an isolated cluster of cumulus clouds were evident on satellite imagery with precipitation revealed on radar. For storm chasers, the target area was a no-brainer, but there was something in the target area of great concern. Trees.
Time is 3:49. We're getting rotation over Elmer City. This thing looks like it wants to produce early. Probably get to the storm instead of messing around with this lightning. It's not tornado warm, but it could drop. Here she comes. It's not tornado warned.
911, what's the address to emergency?
Hi, there's a tornado on the ground. I need to report it. It's
east of Katie?
Yes, it's in Katie.
All right, we got it, sir.
All right.
Thank you.
It's coming right for me.
Storm chasers call eastern Oklahoma the jungle, and if you chase here in the jungle, you run the risk of being oblivious of a tornado less than a quarter mile away. Here I'm taking a huge gamble that I'll be able to find a closer clearing to observe this approaching tornado. This time the gamble paid off big time. A driveway leading up an elevated clearing would provide the perfect view. The only catch was it was directly in the tornado's path.
Alright, escape plan here.
With two cameras running, one super wide and one tight, the plan was to hold my post as long as possible and hope the tornado changed directions. The turbulent roar of the tornado becomes audible as it creeps closer. This ominous, bending creature is passing to my south, but unfortunately closing in on someone's home. It undergoes an intense strengthening trend, ripping up trees and spitting them out like weeds under a lawnmower.
I think we're good so far.
And in seconds, someone's home is obliterated and scattered 100 meters into the air. The house didn't even sustain a direct hit, yet the entire roof is sucked off its walls. The rest demolished. A tree hovers above the ground, and a man loses his life. Roof trusses and 8-foot-long 2x4s are still whirling around the tornado like feathers. The once home was overrun by a powerful river of air feeding into the tornado known as the rear inflow jet, evident in a turbulent mist trailing well behind the more concentrated condensation funnel. Powerful tornadoes sometimes develop horizontal vortices stretching out like dexterous arms on a giant carnivorous plant. Chasers have nicknamed these vortices noodles, but that nickname hardly justifies their sinister reaching. I call them tendrils.
sky above me right now, people. You wouldn't believe this. Here comes the big ones. If we can get up on top of a hill or a clearing, we're gonna have an epic shot. And there, oh my god, mile wide, significant tornado, at least EF4. You've gotta see this. Unfortunately, people are not. I can't get out of the trees. And there it is. Massive. Oh, man. I would say, except this is really bad for somebody.
This extremely dangerous tornado is growing to over a mile wide in width and tracking over several rural homes. Unanchored homes, mobile homes, and outbuildings will be leveled or completely swept away. A large metal storage garage would be swept away and the vehicles inside it thrown up to 280 yards. A nearby mobile radar recorded winds over 200 miles per hour, indicating this tornado was likely capable of producing EF5 damage. And right about now, a young man is taking shelter in his home's most interior room while his entire house around him is being violently demolished. Only the two walls and toilet he is clinging to will remain. He will walk away without a scratch.
Excuse the shaking, this road is not... Oh my god, is this really happening? Is this really happening? If I can... Roman law. Nothing left but a chimney right here. Boom, to get over there. How do I get to that house? I'm not going through there.
Though a hellish swath of widespread high-end EF3 damage occurred, there were no fatalities associated with this second tornado.
Oh, driving under a power line. All right, we're gonna check these houses for people. The tornado.
Perhaps it was a miracle, perhaps it was luck. But one thing for sure, if you listen to weather warnings and have a plan in the event of severe weather, you'll greatly increase your odds of survival.
Oh, are you all right, Cal? Are you all right, dude? You hungry? Have some food? Not too upset by this, are you?
In the event of a tornado warning, get to the lowest level of a sturdy structure and put as many walls between you and the outside chaos as possible. Bathroom, a closet, whatever is in the center away from windows. When it comes to tornado safety, there are no guarantees, but in most cases, this advice works. If you live on the top floor of a small apartment or something that doesn't really have a center interior room, the next time you're outside, strike up a friendly conversation with your neighbors on the lowest level. Yeah, they might be loud and a little weird and sometimes disrespectful, but in the event of a crisis, you'll be surprised how amazing human beings can be. Till next time, friends, happy trails.
Tornado on the right is a new tornado. You got that? That was three tornadoes on the ground.